If you want to know what's going on in Rockingham County government, check out Rockingham County 411. If you're interested in county governmental programs, projects, and services, don't miss Rockingham County 411. Public Information Officer Mable Scott will share important, crucial news you can use with Rockingham County 411.
Today we'd like to ask you to join us in a very serious conversation about Elder Abuse Awareness. Elder Abuse Awareness. And we have two of our experts here from Rockingham County Government, our Adult Protective Services Supervisor, Carye Dickerson, and our Services Program Manager, Cathy Murray. Thank you, ladies, for joining us today.
Thank you for having us.
When I think of elders, I think of people who I respect, I adore, and I just say thank you, thank you, thank you for all you've done to help to make us who we are. How can we even think of having to say elder abuse awareness?
There are several types of elder abuse, and that can include self-neglect, just normal abuse, or exploitation. So a lot of times we see a lot of self-neglect just because they're more secluded in the community than the younger population, and they just need some extra help. Mm-hmm. And that's why we like to step in and provide whatever services we can assist them with.
Okay.
And sometimes, Mabel, you don't even think of elder abuse, but the people that we deal with are anybody over the age of 18. So a lot of us think of the greatest generation, those, mm-hmm. you know, that my parents' age in their
exactly.
80s and 90s. But you look at those people that are anybody over the age of 18 are considered adults, and that's who we're out to protect, somebody that can't take care of themselves anymore for whatever reason, or that someone is exploiting or neglecting or abusing, and that's who our agency is tasked to look after the entire time.
And so what happens when we see this? If by chance one of my neighbors is not properly taking care of his mother or grandmother, what do we do? Do we call you, or and tell us the process of what happens?
Anyone can call into our agency and ask for the Adult Protective Services intake line. We do take calls 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, much like the child abuse intake line. Mm-hmm. And so there's always someone there to answer the phone. And during that conversation that the intake worker has with the caller, they'll talk about the different types of possible abuse, neglect, or exploitation. We will take that report, and then we will go out and check on them if it meets the definition of an actual report.
Okay. And do you get many calls like that?
Yes, we do. Last year in Rockingham County, there were over 250 reports that we investigated, which for a county our size is a lot of reports. You wouldn't think that Little Rockingham County would have that many, but we average above what the counties our size.
And that was my next question. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Compared to the state or nationwide, is that a large number?
It is for a county our size.
And what do you think causes that?
We have an aging population in Rockingham County. We advertise it as a good place to be, but a mm-hmm. lot of people come here and they retire here. Mm-hmm. And that causes a lot of folks, you know, and it's like we see a lot of times they don't have people here to look after them once they get older.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes that happens, and it's like Carye said, they don't take care of themselves like they should. And we get those reports of self-neglect, that they can't take care of themselves any longer. And the exploitation, which that's something different than we see in child welfare. It's where somebody is taking advantage of them, whether they are aware of it or not. Somebody's coming in and they're sending money somewhere or doing things like that mm-hmm. that they shouldn't be doing, mm-hmm. and those types of things.
I love what you all have here. You work to build support for elders and to encourage Rockingham County communities to recognize and celebrate older adults and their ongoing contributions to the success and vitality of our country. And you think about our county, when I see so many of our volunteers who are AARP members and seniors, and you're right, they're contributors.
Mm-hmm.
They're helping to make Rockingham County a better place to live, work, and play. And that's why we should celebrate. So tell us about this big day that was nationwide and also celebrated here in Rockingham County.
So for our county, we wanted to celebrate all the adults that are the protected people that we currently serve. that are a part of our guardianship program in Rockingham County.
Now tell us what that is, guardianship program.
Guardianship program is when an adult doesn't have anyone else to make those medical decisions for themselves, then our agency will take that task on, take that role on.
Mm-hmm.
One of our social workers will take that role.
Okay.
And that's after the adult has been deemed incompetent by the courts.
Okay.
So that just means that they can't make the medical or financial decisions for themselves. And that's at that point when we would step in.
Okay.
So this year, to celebrate them, we decided that we would post 74 pinwheels, purple pinwheels for the color of World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. And we put them out front of the governmental building to celebrate that we help serve those adults that have brought so much to our community for us.
And normally this would have been an event where people would have been invited like we always do with some of the other programs that you do, but because of COVID-19 and social distancing, we couldn't do it like that.
We had a small group of our staff that went out and planted those pinwheels, and we took pictures, which we're going to have posted on our website and things like that, but we couldn't have a group of people. We normally invite all of our partners that work with us with our aging population. We invite those people to come out and help us plant those pinwheels, but we weren't able to do that this year because of COVID-19.
Yeah. World Elder Abuse Awareness Day was back earlier in June, mid-June, and this was celebrated just all over the country, right?
It was.
Yeah, and people understand that this is important because sometimes abuse does occur. How can we all participate in helping to strengthen our communities and prevent elder abuse? Prevent.
By checking on your neighbors, check on your friends, check on your family, and if you suspect any abuse, neglect, or exploitation, please do call our agency to let us know so that we can reach out and assist those people. You know, and just making sure that your neighbor has groceries or that they make it to their doctor's appointments, you know, that they have the transportation they need, and if you can't assist them in the ways that they need, that you give us a call so that we can see what we can do to help as well.
Do you all work with some of our local churches and houses of faith to maybe step in and help too?
We do. So we reach out to the natural resources in the community. You know, if we go out to meet with an adult and they are tied to a church, then we can reach out to that church to see if they can assist that family as well.
And if there are groups or organizations that have presentations where they need people to come out and speak, you all are available to go out and
we are
help to prevent and let folks know all about all of the information that you can provide. Okay. What are some of the warning signs or some of the things that we as good neighbors or friends can maybe notice or pick up on?
When you see someone who's not taking care of themselves like they used to, if you, you know, and with COVID-19, it's been difficult for everybody to go have their hair done and things like that. But
very hard.
But, you know, if you notice someone who always used to dress very nicely, and maybe that has changed for them, that they're not taking care of themselves the way they used to. Either sudden loss of weight or sudden gain weight, those types of situations where they're just maybe not themselves like they used to be, that's a warning sign, and you may need to be talking to them about what's going on. You know, are they, sometimes you'll see lots of old people, older people have sundowners where they're really confused maybe at night, in the evening, they're fine during the day.
Okay.
And that's an early warning sign possibly of Alzheimer's or something like that. And you're seeing those things. Lots of times we run into folks that their cars have lots of body damage to them where they've had accidents and things in the cars and you don't know, and they don't know how those kinds of things happen. And you see that, you know, and those are, you know, you question those kinds of things. Talk to their family about them. Have you noticed any changes in your neighbors and those types of things? Confusion. But lots of times you'll see folks that aren't just taking care of themselves like they used to. And especially, like I said, with COVID-19, you know, people aren't out like they used to be. And that's something that you may need to check on. Have you seen your neighbor picking up her newspaper or going to the mailbox? Those types of things. Check on them, make sure that they're okay, make sure that they've got groceries, all of those types of things are what we need to be looking for.
And I guess one of the things that came to my mind was I've seen stories where people have been using senior citizens' monies and resources. And how do you even pick up on some of that?
A lot of the times banks will actually make a report if they see a lot of transactions that are not like what they had previously seen on that account, they will also make reports to our agency.
And so when you hear from those people at the banks, then you all can follow up
mm-hmm.
to see what's mm-hmm. going on. Mm-hmm. So I guess it's good, too, for seniors to be actively involved in some of the programs that we have here in Rockingham County.
Yes, ma'am.
For socialization.
Mm-hmm. It is. And the things, too, there's lots of programs, Meals on Wheels and those types of things, where people will come to their house and bring a meal, you know, a couple of times a week or once a week. And those are very good eyes in the community that go out and, you know, they will notice, you know, they're not quite like they were last week mm-hmm. or first of the week and those types of things, or the house isn't like it should be. And those, that always helps.
That's a wonderful program.
It is a wonderful program. And it has been here for years and years and years.
Yes, and when you deliver the meals, I think sometimes you can tell, well, this conversation could go on and on and mm-hmm. on, and mm-hmm. you can just reap so many good benefits listening to the seniors and hearing some of their advice. Mm-hmm. So what else can all of us do as a community? You're saying be sure to check on our neighbors, be sure to look closely. If you see something, say something. Anything else you'd like to really kind of reinforce and tell us?
Engage with your neighbors, the older population of our community. You know, they have mm-hmm. a lot to offer to us, like we've said. Mm-hmm. And I think that they probably don't get as much socialization as they could need to have. Mm-hmm. And so just getting out there, talking to them, inviting them to go with you, obviously with the social distancing mm-hmm. in place, just making them participate with you in the community on different things.
How did you all end up with these particular careers?
I started in child welfare, and then just...
Did you always want to be a social worker?
I did, yes ma'am. So I started in child welfare, and then I decided that I wanted to work with the adult population
And you're enjoying it?
I am enjoying it.
Good. And Cathy?
When I came to DSS, I started out in long-term care Medicaid. That's where I started out. So I did that side of it, and then came up through child welfare, and then now I do child welfare and adult services. So
is it difficult?
Kind of a natural transition.
Is it difficult?
It has its great days, and then there's harder days.
Yeah. Yeah. You see it all. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, Rockingham County has everything.
But we also do see some great things happening in the community mm-hmm. by the residents and the partners that we work with as an agency to help serve these older mm-hmm. adults. Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of support from law enforcement and the district attorney's office, and then other agencies like Help Incorporated in the community that are really great.
Mm-hmm. Partners, like helping partners.
Partners, and we have a good number of rest homes and family care homes here in our county that help to take care of a lot of folks here in our county. And just recently, during COVID-19, we partnered with our emergency operations staff.
That was a wonderful story.
And you had those pictures, I think. And mm-hmm. we were handed out a lot of PPE equipment and things like that. And that was a wonderful thing. So unexpected, I think. But you know, we were able to do that with them, and that was a good partnership. But we work with a lot of those folks from the emergency operations staff and EMS.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And when you have those difficult days, what kicks in to say, hey, I got to get through this, we got to help this particular customer, this client, this patient?
Just knowing that someone else is still out there that needs that help, you know,
yes.
that keeps us going, I feel like. We definitely have mm-hmm. the desire to help serve our community and make things better.
Mm-hmm. What's one of the best stories that you could share but not get into a confidentiality issue?
I think
we had I know our QA was going out with one of our workers.
What's a QA?
Our quality assurance person.
Oh, in manufacturing. Okay.
And she went out, and the lady that they went to see kissed her on the forehead one day, and you know, and it was just, you don't expect that or anything like that. And we, you know, lots of times these older adults especially, they really thank you for everything that you do.
They appreciate you.
They're very appreciative of what you do for them and those kinds of things. You know, they don't like to be, sometimes we have to do things and remove them from their surroundings and things mm-hmm. like that. Mm-hmm. And they don't understand lots of times due to mm-hmm. cognitive issues and things.
Yes.
But they appreciate what you do. But, you know, that was a funny story that day.
And that's a wonderful way to show how much she appreciated.
Yeah.
And I've heard a story similar to that with Meals on Wheels, where someone was delivering meals, and the person receiving the meal said, told this person, "Oh, you're such a good-looking young man." She stretched out her little arms, and we've had cases where people have said, "You want to take a picture of me?" And it's great. Mm-hmm. And we all have to understand that seniors are so important to all of us and mm-hmm. our lives, and how many of us were nurtured and taken care of mm-hmm. by people who were much, much older. So mm-hmm. we appreciate our seniors, and we appreciate you all for taking care of all of the adults here in Rockingham County. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having us.
Yes.
Thank you, Mabel.
Rockingham County 411, you're in a good place.